What's up, ladies and gentlemen of Cyberlands? So I'm coming back with another Marvel Cinematic Universe review for the Infinity Saga. Thor, The Dark World, or I like to call it Thor 2. So with Thor, we are picking up, I think, literally right after the Avengers. And I think it's on the same timeline, like literally happened at the same time as Iron Man 3. However, I still also feel kind of that Iron Man 3 might be 6 months after Avengers, per se, like when it starts to really pick up. And we see Loki on trial for the crimes he committed, I believe, not only in Thor, but also especially Avengers, because it is stated. And one thing I noticed about Loki in at the beginning of the film is that his mindset is completely, I would say, skewered, fragile, maybe, his mind, you know, just, he literally does not give a shit about anything at this point. And I think his goal originally was in Thor to get the acknowledgement that he hadn't received from, he felt he wasn't receiving from his parents. And I think at this point, he just doesn't care. He's just kind of like, I'm never going to receive that acknowledgement. I'm never going to be accepted no matter what I do. So might as well just say, fuck it. And just, you know, do whatever I want. If that means killing people, or if that means, you know, just being an ass. Like, what's the point at this? You know, I'm not going to be accepted, you know. And of course, you know, his behavior in this scene, you know, I wouldn't say gets him thrown in prison, but he had earned it anyway. And we see Thor just trying to fix a lot of damage that I think was caused because of what Loki had done in Thor, as you know, and he's working with his mates that he had in the first Thor. We also see Jan, his love interest from Thor 1, stumbling across some type of dimension, I think another portal, I guess you could say, and she comes across this this red mist, I guess you could say, that goes into her body and starts kind of doing damage to her. Fast forward, we also find that the villain, the Dark Elves, they are trying to get control of that power and then extract it from her. If they have to kill her to do it, they will. And during this whole time, we see we get to see more of just Thor becoming a better person, and also being more like his father wanted him to be. And what's interesting is we see in this film, and of course, you know, Odin has a reason to act this way, but we also see that Thor is acting more like his father in the first film, and Odin is kind of acting like how Thor was in the first film before when Odin kicked him out of Isengard. Or, I'm sorry, Asgard. And we see that going. So that was kind of interesting when I look back on this film. And that's pretty much it. You have the villains. You have Thor trying to stop them. It's a straightforward film. There wasn't anything in this film that was surprising to me. I wasn't shocked. It wasn't badly written. It just didn't have anything where I was like, I wasn't as amazed about it as the first Thor. Like, the first Thor I really enjoyed. The second one, not too much. But my reasoning behind Thor 2 I didn't enjoy as much is really a few. It's not a lot of things. It was a few things. Number one, the villain was very whatever. They were just there. And Marvel, yes, you know, Marvel doesn't always, you know, raise the bar high on their villains. Sometimes they fall short. It's just, you know, it is what it is. This villain, I just, you know, I was like, whatever. I just felt like it was too straightforward with their goals. Felt it could have been maybe hashed out a little better. As far as the characters, though, Odin, I forget her name. I know Rene Russo, but I forget. Okay, Rene Russo's character, who was Thor's mother, I forget her name. She was wonderful. I was glad to see her more in scenes than she had in the first one. I thought she was great. Natalie Portman, aside from her attitude about Marvel, I felt she was fine. I enjoyed all the characters. outside of the Dark Elves, I mean, the battle scenes were great. I felt the action was better than the first one. It's just in regards to the villain was just weaker to me than the first one. Even though the villain was kind of, you know, it's a little questionable if there really was a villain. My favorite scenes and interactions was really with Thor and Loki. I liked that the most out of the whole film because, and I feel Tom Hiddleston, I felt he stole the show again. He's a great actor, but as Loki, he's just wonderful because it's not just necessarily he has to be a villain. It's just his mannerism, how he interacts with other characters, how he talks to others, how he just presents himself. He just carries himself very well, and I really enjoyed that with Thor 2, including 1. My rating for the film, I'm not going to give it a 3. I wouldn't give it a 5 either. I'd just settle with a 4. Because there was a lot of stuff I did like about the film, and there was things that could have been better. I just felt the thing that was lacking with Thor 2, or the Dark World, was the villain. I felt the villain just wasn't strong enough to keep me entertained. Now, is it like Captain Marvel? Fuck no. Hell no, it's not like Captain Marvel. I can still watch Thor 2 and enjoy it because it has so much things I did like. However, you know, the villain just wasn't very good. But again, well, not again, but it's cool to see when you rewatch these films after you've seen the whole saga and you see these bits and pieces, these little Easter eggs, if you can call it that, and they're coming through, and you say, oh, that's what this is. That's what this is. Oh, that right there. You know, it's cool to continue to see that. And when all the pieces are coming in together to form the puzzle, when it all makes sense, it all comes. And again, I got to give Marvel credit for that, even though they fell short on little things with villains, they did have a good idea when they were putting everything together to end the Infinity Saga. So I am happy about that. So with that being said, you know, would I say you need to watch Thor? That's a personal preference. There are things in it that do help later with the other films. It's entertaining. It's just, I would say, just don't expect to be better than 1. And don't expect the villain to be as great. If you can get past that and enjoy it's entertaining, enjoy everything else about it, then, you know, I would say check it out. So with that being said, we will be doing an upcoming review that will be with my favorite Avengers film, or not Avengers film, my favorite Marvel film, hands down, Captain America, Winter Soldier. So with that being said, I will see you guys on the next one. Take care.